Today we are going to try changing this image to a bright golden light setting with the free Snapseed app. After importing the image to Snapseed, first I'm going to straighten the image with the rotate tool. Auto straighten works pretty well here. Next, using the perspective tool with the tilt option, I'm going to tilt it vertically just a bit. Now I'm going to crop the image a bit on the left so that the center of the tower is right in the middle. Using the healing tool, I'm going to clear these objects in the sky. Precisely selecting them works well here. I'm going to save this copy, which is later needed. As I'm planning to replace the sky, I'm going to create some blending images which will help in replacing the sky more easily. That is, in this instance, turn this to a black and white image. To do that, first in Tune Image, I'm going to increase the saturation to maximum, which will help in the next step. Opening black and white filter, we will get a nice contrast selecting the blue color option. Also select contrast option for more contrast. Now with curves, I'm going to try changing the whole foreground to black. Dragging most of the bottom part of the curve towards right will get you the result. Tune it till you make the foreground as much black as possible. You can still notice some white spots which needs to be black. Again using curves, dragging the top point down turns the image black. With masking, tapping on the stacks icon, view edits, the latest curves and brush. With the effect disabled and the brush value at 100, brushing on the white spots to turn them black. Saving this copy, which is later needed. Using double exposure, I'm going to add the earlier saved image. And choose the add option which turns the background to complete white. But the foreground remains the same. Saving this again. Going to view edits, I'm going to delete this last effect applied. Now I'm going to invert this image by going to curves and dragging the top right point down and the bottom point to the top. I'm saving this as a copy. All three images saved will help in replacing the sky more easily. Now I'm going to close Snapseed and import the earlier saved image with the black foreground as a new image. Going straight to double exposure option and adding a new evening sky image with the darken blend mode option, which replaces only the white part of the image. Placing the image at a suitable position. Applying it. Again with double exposure, adding another saved image of the white foreground and black background. With the lightened blend mode, the black from the earlier image turns to white. Next, adding the image with the white background and selecting Subtract Blend Mode, which replaces the white with the new image. Now we are gonna blend the image and tune further to get the desired results. First thing you notice is the harsh sunlight which has created shadows. I'm gonna try removing the harsh light here using selective filters. Placing one here to select the area of the harsh light and reducing the brightness to match with the shadows on the right. Also tuning the saturation structure and contrast to try to match it as close as possible. another one here on the wall. Reducing the brightness. One here on the tower. Another one here. One more selective filter to darken this tree. The filters have darkened the subject a bit. With masking, I'm gonna brush out the masks to get brightness back on the subject. Next, I'm going to apply global contrast by selecting soft contrast preset in curves. To make the image more interesting, I'm going to apply vintage filter with preset 12 for a soft dark vignette. With masking, I'm going to mask out part of the structure to bring light back. Also bringing light back in part of the sky. Next, I'm going to try giving more color and brightness to the floor in the foreground by increasing brightness, contrast and warmth. Applying it with masking. Some selective contrast on the structure, this time again with the soft contrast in curves. And applying it with masking. To give the temple more texture, increasing structure in details menu, then masking it. The face of the subject pop a bit, I'm going to use the portrait filter. If it doesn't detect the face the first time, tap try harder button few times. Eventually it will detect the face. Applying combo 2 preset here, which makes the face pop. It has also made the surroundings darker, so making a mask just on the face. Using curves, lifting the blacks and also adding yellows by dragging the top point of the blue curve down. With masking, applying it to make the top right part of the sky brighter. The final result here. Thanks for watching.